She was another stand-up comic. She was in her late 40s. She was a very vibrant, cheeky person. I'm here today to try and help spread awareness, to try and encourage people to become involved in helping Ovarian Cancer Action, because they're a relatively small organisation, but they are doing very important work, and it's a disease we need to know more about and we need more research on.
I became involved with this charity because of something that happened directly to me. I was happily married to my wife Polly, and out of the blue she had to go and have a hysterectomy, and during the operation they discovered she had ovarian cancer, and it was quite well advanced, and you know, of course it rocked my life and all around us, and of course especially her life. She was amazingly brave and fought this for a sort of four-year battle, and then she died.
There are a couple of fundamental issues that we're interested in. One issue is, of course, how to cure this disease and eradicate it. And where we can't cure and eradicate it, how we turn it from a lethal disease into one that is survivable, where people can live a reasonable and good quality life with it. The most important issue for a patient is hope. And actually, the knowledge that we are all working towards this can transform a patient's experience in itself.
When I was diagnosed, I just thought I had irritable bowel syndrome or diverticulitis. I just never connected sort of stomach cramps and bloatedness with ovarian cancer. I didn't know anything about ovarian cancer. So it was the last thing on my mind when I went to my GP. I think it's important that women are made aware of the symptoms.
It's best to check if you've got any abnormal feelings, just to be safe. Better to be safe than sorry, really, because it can happen to young girls. I'm proof that it can happen.
We all know who our own bodies, and I think from having this I've learnt a bit more about my body, and I know now that, you know, life's too precious, and if I think I've got a symptom again, I'll go back to the doctor. I'd rather bother a doctor initially than have the doctor spending more time bothering with me later on.
Detecting ovarian cancer early can make all the difference between getting treatment that will save your life and only being able to treat to relieve the symptoms. I would far rather that I had 100 consultations where I could reassure women who weren't at risk instead of the risk of missing one case of ovarian cancer.
The charity's grown enormously. At the beginning it was such a struggle, we would knock on lots of doors, and sometimes we were lucky and sometimes we weren't so lucky. And then we got Marks and Spencers on board as a sponsor, and they sold pin badges for us with the symptoms of ovarian cancer. And just having the badges out there, we got such a response from women with ovarian cancer who were so pleased to see something was being done.
I saw a box of turquoise pins on the counter, and you're so used to seeing pink ones that they sort of caught my attention because they were turquoise.
And my cleaner gave me the pin and the card and said, read this, it might change your life.
Well, it was so important to me to see ovarian cancer in women's magazines and in the media, and for women to talk about it, because there's such a myth about it being a silent cancer.
For the past 4 years on S Magazine, we've done a pink issue every September to highlight the breast cancer awareness. But this year, I thought that it was important for S Magazine to do something different. Frankly, I was surprised by how good the response was. I mean, it surpassed my expectations. And it was such a pleasure working with Ovarian Cancer Action and having such a positive response that I'm really hoping that this great relationship will continue in the future.
Working with a charity like Ovarian Cancer Action is very inspiring for us, both for our staff and for our clients. The event last year, the first Love Art Auction, was very successful. We got lots of tremendous feedback from people who were really touched by some of the things that they learned about the ovarian cancer itself and the work that the charity is doing.
Probably the most important area is funding research, because without research we're not going to get the scientific answers, and that's what we need, scientific answers to tell us how to diagnose better, how to treat better, and how to save lives.
This disease has been isolated for too long, and where we look to see where people have voted with their feet and become aware and influence the power structures, if you like, such as in situations like AIDS and in breast cancer, we've seen dramatic advances in those diseases.
The more that I can help to spread awareness and encourage people to get involved and help, the better.
Because I really do think that, you know, we have potential to save many, many, many women's lives, and I can't think of anything better than doing that.